How did you find out that you were being cheated on?
I got an anonymous email from the other woman. She said she wanted to let me know she just found out that the man she'd been seeing for 7 months was married, with a new baby, and that she was terribly sorry but that she had broken it off. She said she had no idea. She found out he was married by Googling him. Our wedding picture had showed up in my university's alumni wedding album. Then she Googled me, found out where I worked, and called asking for me. They told her I was out on maternity leave with our second child. Kudos to this woman for doing the right thing. I think of her often, especially now that I'm enjoying life more without him. Found out when my 3-year-old son mentioned he didn't like the guy, wife confessed and left to be with him, abandoning our 3-year-old son and 1-year-old daughter. That was 10 years ago and she hasn't seen the children since. The other guy answered her phone and said there was a new sheriff in town. I walked in on her with my roommate. He told her I was cheating on her, which I wasn't, and manipulated her into getting back at me by screwing him. Totally ruined me, haven't been the same since, and that was 5 years ago. Same time I picked up the bottle. Did you at least kill your roommate?
No, he ended up marrying her, got her pregnant. They're both miserable now, and I love it, but still, I think I won. It was incredible for its lack of drama. She simply told me she had cheated on me, and that it would not occur again. I am a fairly relaxed, forgiving person. Everyone deserves a second chance. So we simply try to move on from there, put it behind us. In the end it fell apart anyway, and we are now friends. Remember kids, life is far too short to spend it angry. We all live 80 years or so, then we die. There is no point wasting your time being angry at someone for something they did, just move the fuck on and enjoy the rest of your short lives. Making out with her at a party after dating for about 2 months, I was informed by her other boyfriend that he was dating her. Everyone else at the party knew but me and him. It was his house, so I left. I made the perfect exit, the one everyone wishes they had made. I told her it was over and walked out without looking back, while she begged me not to leave. Then I ruined it by begging her to take me back a week later. And having sex with my ex? But we were on a break, right? Right? I might be pregnant, and if I am, it's not yours. When the DNA test came back and there was 0.0% probability that I was the father. That was when she told me she had banged 5 guys while we broke up for a month, and had sex with a youth minister 2 months after we got back together. Fucking seriously? Apparently the father was the youth minister. I spent 9 months of hell trying to make it work, be there, be supportive, pass my classes, and work. She was my first girlfriend, and fuck you, Angela. She just told me out of the blue. Called her one night to say goodnight, night baby. Don't call me that anymore. What the hell? Then a guy's voice follows on the phone, basically threatening violence against me if I called again, and numerous expletives. Like I did anything wrong? Anyways, she had apparently been banging random dudes for weeks and just decided randomly to tell me. I guess it's better than finding out some other way, but fuck if it's still not depressing. His logic: if I block her from seeing certain posts on Facebook, there is no way of her finding out. Photo stream. Who knew those pictures automatically made their way from your iPhone to your Mac? I did. Told her I saw pictures of her with another guy. She broke down and told me about it. I never saw pictures. I just had a suspicion she was a cheater. Then she got pissed at me for not having any pictures. Night before we had a heated argument, he stormed out while being drunk. Next morning he comes home, we talk, we hug. We cuddle while sitting on the bed. I notice scratches on his back. I ask him what are those scratches. He freezes up and said that his back was itchy so he scratched it. Then there was this whole monologue of me asking if he thinks I'm an idiot and who was the girl. Apparently it was my friend. I ditched the friend, forgave my fiancé and married him a few months later. A part of me just didn't want to throw out all those wedding plans and cancel. We divorced 1.5 years later. I came home after work and she had left my computer on. With Facebook open on the conversations page. Nothing abnormal about that, she often forgot it.
Usually I would close Facebook without even glancing at it. But now my eye fell on the last thing her male best friend had replied to her. "I can't wait to come in your tiny little mouth again." She blamed me for her cheating on me. Craigslist. I saw he had messages from there and just assumed, so I made a post saying I wanted to hook up. He answered. Hell ensued. End of story. Went through my boyfriend's phone and found him asking his ex for sex. Didn't catch the actual act, but the intent was enough. Fuck him. When the dad of my two children, 1.5 years and 6 weeks, said to me, "Can my girlfriend move in? She can help you with the baby." Both times they flat out told me. Yep. Both times. My wife came home one day and told me she had been seeing someone else. And that she was pregnant. Not me, but my brother came home and caught his ex-fiancée sucking and blowing on some dude's dick. She was a weird chick anyway. Heavily into vampires and Twilight and shit. Apparently the dude was some goth asshole that was into the same nonsense, because when my brother walked in and caught them in the act, the goth dude held up his arms and said, "Do not see me," like he was a vampire or had magic or something. Finding a used condom in the bin beside her bed. And then got the chat of, "I love you but I'm not in love with you." Oh, and my other ex. She was caught in the local bar snogging and feeling up some other guy who was a long-term family friend. Boyfriend came to my apartment drunk. Passed out. Went through his phone and he was cheating with 3 women according to texts. Creepy part was he had about 30 screenshots of different women's Facebook profile pictures. Some pics were even cropped to look like it was an actual picture he took. I found out my girlfriend was cheating on me when her mom told me. We had been dating for about 3 years and my girlfriend's mom and I got along great. No father in the picture. She called me one day at work and said she needed to talk to me. Told me where they met and who the guy was. I went there, saw her car and his, and left. When my girlfriend returned home, I informed her that I knew. Never told her how. My ex-girlfriend's mom and I are still friends to this day. iCloud. Locate my iPhone. Worked wonders when my ex mysteriously wanted to borrow the car. A series of events. It began when there was almost no sex in our life after 9 years in our relationship. Then one of our mutual friends started hanging around more and more. And then one night I was coming home for lunch at 2 a.m. as I was working a night shift, I opened the door and there was a bunch of scurrying in the living room. I can pretty much see the whole living room as soon as I open the door, except due to the layout of the furniture I can only see the backs of the chairs slash couch. This friend was apparently laying down on the couch while my wife was sitting in the chair next to him. I try to as calmly as I can ask him to leave, and before he can even get out the door, a screaming match between me and my wife ensue. Long story short, I asked her if she was fucking around on me, to which of course she denied, and at the end of the fight she wanted me to go and apologize to Buddy. So being the coward I was, assuming I was just being an ass about everything, I went to his place the next day and apologized. The following day I went to work, and on my lunch I walked across the street to the mall where my wife worked and was going to see if she could take a break so we could have a bite to eat together. So I walked into her place of employment and asked where she was, and one of her co-workers looked at me puzzled, saying she called into work sick. So of course I'm pissed, because I know she was supposed to be at work and she sent me a message earlier saying she was going into work. So before doing anything rash this time, I go back to work, try and calm myself down the best I can and finish my day. The plan was to pick her up from work afterwards, so that's what I go to do. I get there and I pick her up and was pretending like nothing happened and that I knew nothing. So I asked, "You have a good day at work?" "Yup." "Did you break any more bottles of wine today?" I said this with a little chuckle, as she just started this job and mentioned the day before that she dropped and broke a bottle of wine. No, but insert co-worker's name, dropped a whole case and made a huge mess, ha ha ha. Oh god, that must have been funny. "Yeah, it was." "You sure you had a good day at work?" "Yeah, I'm really starting to like it here." So this is all going on as I'm driving us home, and once we get there and get in the house, I asked her, "Are you sure you had a good day at work?" And she again said yes, and that's when I dropped the well. When I came to see if you wanted to have lunch together, your co-worker said you called in sick. Her face went pale and then her usual reaction started to yell and scream at me with her storming out of the house saying that she was going to spend the night at her mom's. Fast forward to the next evening where she said that she was going to go across the river, live on a border city with the US, with her girlfriends and will call or message if she's going to be late. She also had me go look at her father's computer as it was acting up. So I went there, fixed his computer and talked with him for a bit. His wife had just recently left him for her first boyfriend who lived 3 hours out of town. Went home and dicked around for a bit to kill time until she came home. 1 a.m. rolls around, nothing. 2, 3, 4 a.m. still nothing, so now I'm starting to get worried and call her girlfriends to see what is going on, but I can't get an answer from anyone. 6 a.m. I decide this is enough and drive to one of her girlfriends, but no lights are on. Same with the other one. So I go back home freaking out. Around 8 a.m. one of her girlfriends calls me back as she saw that I called. I explained the situation and she said that they decided that they weren't going across the river and that my wife left with the other girl she was supposed to go across with around 10 p.m. last night. So now fuming, I get in my car and go to this other girl's place and start pounding on the door. And when she opened the door, I could tell by the look on her face and the fact that she was shaking in fear what was going on. I asked her if she was there, she said no. I asked, can you at least tell me if she's okay, and she said she was okay and that she was just going to pick her up and drive her home so we could talk. So I left, got in my car and waited just around the corner so she couldn't see me. And when she left, I started tailing her, but again I already knew where she was going. She pulled up to the place where asshole, from the beginning of this story, lived, and out she walked. She got my car and I just had to hear her say it, so I asked and she said yes. I asked why and she said she wanted to do something to make her happy. I was at work on the graveyard shift, she was at a party with her friends and some kids she hadn't seen since high school. I went home after work and had a terrible nightmare of her cheating on me with Ryan, a guy she had a crush on his high school, but they never dated. When she texted me later that morning and asked how I slept, I told her about the dream and she just sort of changed the subject. At that point I kind of knew but didn't. 3 days later I was on my way up to visit her, when we were face to face she told me she cheated on me with Ryan. My dream was painfully spot on. It took a lot, but I took some time and decided to forgive her. Lot of good it did me. She left me 5 months because I cared about her too much. Fuck, I hate my life sometimes. Which one? First girlfriend, she just straight up told me she had been back with her ex-BF that she had before me. Lied about it for 5 months though. Said I was too great and I deserved better than her. Second girlfriend, it was the morning of her senior homecoming, we went to different schools, and she was acting strange on the phone, so I asked her what's up. And she just starts bawling over the phone. She had slept, sexted, had phone sex, etc. with her boss, who is 40 years older than her. She'd just turned 18 a week before this and it had been going on for 4 months. She tried to put the blame on me, saying I was getting too serious, 2 years of dating ain't serious. She said I was a perfect boyfriend that deserves a perfect girlfriend. Third girlfriend, I was visiting her in Chicago over summer break after our freshman year in college together. We were laying on the couch and looking at pictures on her phone and she gets a text. I mention it to her because the lie was kind of annoying and she just says it's an email. I tell her I know what the text symbol looks like. Anyway, she goes and grabs us some water and I can hear the text notification going of like 7 times. She goes to bed. I don't sleep that night. The next morning she has an adult soccer league game which I go and support her at. She's acting really fishy that morning too. I hold her stuff while she plays and I watch, thinking what the fuck am I gonna do? Her phone goes off like 9 or 10 times in the first half. I had to look. I find out she has been cheating on me with her cousin's best friend all summer and she was planning on breaking up with me after this big trip we had planned the following month to Minnesota. I see pictures of him, pictures of her, some of which she had also sent to me. I confront her, she tries to put the blame on me. We fight, obviously, and I just leave. She says I am too good of a boyfriend and I needed to call her a bitch more. I take the train to downtown Chicago and I only have $20 in my name and my bag full of clothes. My bus was leaving in 3 days. I was too embarrassed to tell my dad that another girl had cheated on me, so I stayed at a hostel one night, the train station another, and didn't sleep the last one. I was almost killed on multiple occasions, one time even being saved by a random person when a hobo pulled out a knife on me. That also marked a year's worth long of stuff that has really kind of fucked me up. That year-long journey ended in May of this year with my father dying. About 2 or 3 years after we broke up, his ex before me emailed me to say she was sorry for sleeping with him for the majority of our 1.5 year relationship. I always suspected it, but he kept insisting that I was just an overly jealous girlfriend. He even told his mom and friends I had crazy, unfounded insecurities regarding him and his ex. After he broke up with me, I felt like shit. I thought I was insane and overly jealous, and no guy would ever want me. It was nice getting closure, even if it was years later. Lent me his iPad. He was always secretive with his phone, but he always went through mine, so I saw that his email was open and I checked the sent messages out of curiosity. Found very explicit pictures of him with another girl during the time we were together. I got a phone call at 11:30 at night on Christmas Eve, bluntly asking, "Why is your wife fucking my husband?"